Traders, FS Pickle at the here. Today is Wednesday, September 18th, and I'm going to be analyzing the Euro-Yen starting on the monthly, working my way all the way down to the 1 hour time frame for the full top-down analysis. So today is the big FOMC interest rate news for the US dollar. This is not a US dollar pair, but this is a risk-on, risk-off pair, the yen is. So if the dollar goes down, normally the yen goes up. If the yen dollar goes up, normally the yen goes down. So definitely keep that in mind. I still think this is likely the end of a wave three. I still think this needs to make like a three-way pattern, probably down to at least a 50% for a wave four before it potentially goes back up for a wave five. So taking it down to the weekly time frame, I still think this first push down is a wave A. I still think it needs to make another push up, which would be a crutch into the wave A for a wave B, and then eventually back down for a wave C, which should be an ABC of four. And now this is a crescent, so it's probably not going to play out that nice and clean, but you know, crescents are very often very, very overlapping, messy patterns. Going down to the daily time frame, now we did have a break of struts at best seen on a little bit of a shorter time frame. I think that pretty much confirms that this over here is the wave A, and this is actually an A, this is actually a B, and I think we may be starting an uptrend, which would likely go up to the 78 or the 68% for a wave C of wave B. This would be an A of 4, this would be a B of 4, then eventually back down for the wave C of wave 4. So taking it down to the 4 hour time frame, this is where you can kind of clearly see that we do finally have a break of Strutzer. Now that we do have a break and a hold above Strutzer, I definitely would be looking for buys at the end of every single pullback I see, especially three wave pullbacks. So taking it right down to the 1 hour time frame. On the 1 hour time frame, definitely very impulsive up. Whether or not this really is the continuation of the uptrend, I think is questionable, because this move down is pretty very impulsive. I kind of feel like it should make more of a three-way pattern, maybe something like that, more of an ABC pattern, you know, one, two, three waves down, impulsive up, before it actually does really end up continuing the uptrend. Now, like I said, this is not a dollar pair, but the yen definitely does get affected by the dollar news. And we actually do have yen interest rate later on this week also, so should be a very big day and a very big week for even the yen pairs. So make sure you stop in and watch my YouTube live stream today for the latest opinion on all your favorite pairs. And don't forget to join my free Discord channel, which is linked over here in the corner. And as always, thank you and happy trading.